Hi, this is Miss Barnacle again. Today we're going to finish our rounding section. This is rounding word problems. And remember, when you are doing rounding, we're looking next door depending on how high they want us to round. If it's 5 or higher, you want to go up one. If it's 0 to 4, you want to leave the digit the same, and then you want to make all the ones behind it zeros. So let's look at a word problem. And this is what we see. We're talking about a family, they traveled, and we want to round and estimate how far they went over their whole entire trip. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the board and I'm going to work this problem out for you. So over the course of their trip, they traveled this many days or this many miles. So what we want to do is we want to round, and it says we're going to round each distance to the nearest hundred. So first thing you need to know is what digit is in the hundreds place. So let's underline them. And in the first four, it's very easy to find the digit in the hundreds place because it's the first one on the left. When you get to the bottom, there's a problem there. It has a zero right now in place of the hundreds place. But we're going to underline it, and we're going to come back to that in just a second. Now we're going to round to the hundreds place. So what does it tell you to do? It tells you to look next door. So if I look next door to 588, if I look next door to the 5, I see an 8. Is that 0 to 4? No, it's 5 or more. Since it's 5 or more, we're going to round it up to 6. And all the digits behind it will become zeros, just like in the previous lesson. Okay, so the next one, I do the same thing. I underline my hundreds digit, which is a 6. I look next door. My number next door is an 8, which is 5 or higher, so I'm going to add one more. So my 6 rounds up to a 7, and the digits behind it drop to zeros. Then I do the same thing for the next one. I underline my hundreds digit, which is a 2. I look next door. Next door, I see a 7, which is definitely 5 or more. So I round my 2 to a 3, and the other digits become zeros. I look at this number. It's the 1 is in the hundreds place. I look next door, and I see a 5. He's 5 or higher, so I'm going to add one more, which makes that 2, and those become zeros. On this last one, there is nothing in place of the hundreds. So I put a 0 here, but I still look next door. And when you look next door, I see 5 or more. So we're going to round this up to 100. That's how we want to do that. And then to find the total, remember back in one of the very first lessons that we did, to find the total, total means to add. So now when you do addition, these first two columns, the 1 column and the tens column, are all zeros, so all you have to do is put zeros in there. And then you want to add your hundreds digits. So that'll be 6 plus 7, that makes 13. 13 plus 3, that makes 16. Plus 2 makes 18, plus 1 makes 19. So that is approximately 1,900 miles that the family has traveled. And that is how you do rounding word problems. There are other examples that are worked out in the notes that you can download and look over. And thank you for joining me.